Hello everyone, a very good morning to all. So far we have discussed about different types of ionic crystal structures. Now in this video we'll be starting with defects in crystal structures. As no crystal is ideal at normal room temperature, at normal conditions of, at standard conditions of temperature and pressure, or we can say normal conditions of temperature and pressure, no crystal is ideal. So the ideal or perfect crystals only exist at absolute zero, that is at the temperature of zero Kelvin only. These perfect or ideal crystals can exist, which we have discussed so far. So as the temperature rises above zero Kelvin, introduction of defects is there. That is due to thermal vibrations. Thermal vibrations start to occur in the crystal system, and those thermal vibrations induces different types of defects. And now we'll be discussing about different types of defects which can be introduced due to these thermal vibrations when the temperature rises above zero Kelvin. As every normal situation temperature is above zero Kelvin, and that is why no crystal can exist as the ideal or perfect one. So based upon the defects, two types of crystal systems are there: stoichiometric crystals and non-stoichiometric crystals. Stoichiometric crystals are also called as daltonite crystals or daltonite compounds, and non-stoichiometric crystals are called as bertholite compounds. So in stoichiometric crystals, defects are introduced in such a manner that number of atoms or ions are exactly in the same ratio as indicated by the formula, as suggested by the stoichiometry, or we can say the stoichiometry of the compound is not disturbed. That is, the law of constant composition is always obeyed in case of stoichiometric compounds, in case of stoichiometric crystals. In case of stoichiometric crystals, while maintaining the stoichiometry, two types of defects are there which can be introduced in the stoichiometric compounds. These are Schottky and Frenkel. Schottky and Frenkel are the scientists of two names. Schottky was a German scientist, and Frenkel was the Russian scientist. So they detected these two types of defects for the first time. So Schottky defect is the one when same number of cations and anions are missing from the crystal, leaving behind holes. So this is, if say this is a crystal, this is a packing system where cations and anions are present adjacent to each other. Cations are represented by C and anions by A. So these spheres are representing both the cations and anions with C and A written inside them. These are present at alternate positions. This is a typical ionic crystal, the sample ionic crystal which we have drawn. So here, if this cation is missing, then for that missing cation, the corresponding anion should be missing. That means same number of cations and anions are missing, leaving behind holes. So these are the holes which have been created after the one cation and anion went missing. So this Schottky defect is observed for crystals where cations and anions are of same size. They are having, inke liye kuch conditions hai na, Schottky defect kin crystals mein hota hai? Schottky defect उन crystals में होगा जिनके लिए ये जो ये conditions fulfill करते हैं हमारी. अब condition one is cation और anion का size almost same होगा, coordination number high होगा, तो ही हमारा Schottky defect आएगा. That means coordination number should be more than 6 or 8. So these are the two conditions which are required for Schottky effects to take place. Schottky defect to take place. Also when same number of cations and anions are missing, that means electrical neutrality is not disturbed. The crystal is remaining neutral, because if some positive ion is missing, then the corresponding negative ion is also missing. So examples to these, the Schottky defect crystals are NaCl, KCl, KBr. So these are the examples where cations are not very, very much smaller in comparison to the corresponding anions. So next is the second type of defect which we have mentioned, is the Frenkel defect. So this is given by the Russian scientist named Frenkel. So this is the defect this defect occurs in the crystals when some ions or atoms, in generally cations, because cations ka size chota hota hai, so generally cations go missing and go missing from their actual position and they occupy some vacant interstitial site present in the crystal. So this type of defect is observed where there is a large difference in the size of cation and anion, and coordination number is low, that is 4 or 6. For Schottky defect, 4 coordination number cannot be there. If the coordination number of 4 is there, that means Schottky defect cannot be there. If coordination number of 8 is there, that means Senkel defect cannot be there. For 6, both can exist. So electrical neutrality is maintained in this case also, because the cation has not left the crystal. It is present in the crystal itself. It has just changed its position from the lattice site to the interstitial site, which was vacant earlier. So electrical neutrality is maintained. The examples of Prandtl defect are zinc sulfide, silver chloride, silver bromide. So this type of defect is generally not found in alkali metal halide, because in case of alkali metal halide, the cations are large enough to have Prandtl defect. Although in case of NaCl, in the structure of NaCl, we have discussed that it exhibits the halide structure because the chloride ions are bigger in size in comparison to sodium, but these are still having a comparable structure, comparable size. That sodium ions are not that smaller in comparison to chloride ions, which if we see the difference between these two ions here, AgCl, and the difference in silver and chloride ion is much greater in comparison to that of the difference between sodium and chloride. So in that context here, it is written that NaCl is having comparable size. So the consequences which are observed after having these defects are that crystals start conducting electricity now, because there is the presence of holes is there in the crystal. The introduction of holes is there. Now, whenever there is a presence of hole, then there comes the option of the movement of charged particles. And whenever there is a movement of charged particle, then there can be, the conductivity starts to exist there whenever there is a movement of charged particle. So here, when in the crystal system, when holes are present, these holes can be occupied by the adjacent cations or the anions based upon the missing vacancy. That if the missing vacancy is belonging to cation, then cation will occupy this. And if say what will happen is this cation will occupy this position, and now this here the hole will be created. And if this network is extended to three dimensional network, and what will happen? There is a movement of charged particles which will start to take place. Similarly here, now this space is vacant. This is position of the cation. Some other cation, say this cation, will come here and this will become vacant. And then after that, this will come here. This will become vacant. So this process goes on, and there is a movement of charged particle which leads to the conduction. So now that there are missing charged particles in case of Schottky, so density is lowered in case of Schottky, but in case of Prandtl, no effect to the density takes place, because the cation, if it is missing from, it is present in the lattice itself. If it is missing from the lattice position, it has occupied the interstitial site. So not much change in density is there, but in case of Schottky, density decreases considerably due to the missing charged particles, missing anions or the cations. So presence of holes also decrease the stability of the crystal, thereby lattice energy is also lowered. So the presence of these defects leads to decrease in lattice energy, because stability of crystal is hampered due to the introduction of holes. Also, the other consequence is that presence of ions in the interstitial sites, this consequence belongs to the Prandtl defect, because there is the cations are present in the interstitial sites. So the presence of cations in the interstitial sites may expand the lattice, because this will lead to increase in the unit cell dimensions, thereby increasing the volume. So yes, in case of Prandtl defect, there are the chances of expansion of the lattice. So also the next consequence which belong to both the defects, that is Schottky and Frenkel, is the closeness of similar charges. Now the charged particles have this is all this if this consequence is also belonging to the Frenkel defect, because now the charged particle, the cation, has left its position and it has acquired the interstitial site. Now it has in this case the closeness of similar charged particle, we can say closeness of cation has increased. So when there is a closeness of similar charges, this will lead to increase in dielectric constant. How the dielectric constant is increasing? Because whenever there is a closeness of similar charged particle, what happens is the electric field produced per unit area increases. And whenever there is a closeness of, and what is dielectric constant? By dielectric constant, we mean that whenever we apply electric field, the charged particles will align themselves along the direction of electric field and then produces the electric field opposing the applied electric field and decreases the overall effect of the applied electric field. Now, there is closeness of charged particle, then they will produce increased electric field, increased opposing electric field, which will then increase the overall dielectric constant of the crystal. So next type of defects are the non-stoichiometric. So far we have discussed two types of defects, which belong to the stoichiometric compounds. Now the defects present in non-stoichiometric compounds. In case of non-stoichiometric compounds, the ratio of one type of atoms to that of the other type of atom does not correspond exactly to the exact whole number ratio as depicted by the formula. Say the formula is AB, where A is a cation and B is the anion. So then in case of non-stoichiometric defects, here the ratio as depicted by the formula is 1:1. But in case when there is non-stoichiometric defect in such type of compound, the ratio does not remain 1:1. It will become 1:0.97. It will become 1:0.98. That some of the cations or anions goes missing, which are reflected in the actual formula. So we can say that law of constant composition is not obeyed. The examples are oxides and sulfides of transition elements, that is iron oxide, iron sulfide, copper sulfide. So here iron oxide, which is represented as FeO, where cation is iron and anion is oxygen, where the ratio is 1:1. The actual formula ranges from Fe.84 to Fe.94 to oxygen, which is 1. So here also electrical neutrality is maintained. So to maintain the electrical neutrality, what are the possible layouts? The possible layouts in such cases for maintaining the electrical neutrality, that there must be extra electron present in the interstitial site, or if we have here iron is missing, that means positive charge is less. So if iron is present in +2 oxidation state, then some of the neighboring irons will acquire higher charge to maintain the neutrality of the charge. So these are the two wayouts. Let us see. In case of non-stoichiometric compounds, two types of defects are there which exist, that is metal excess defect and metal deficiency. Metal excess defect can occur in two ways. One is through anion vacancy. If anion is vacant, then also there is a excess of cation or metal. The second way out is extra cation occupying the interstitial site. So for anion vacancy, as I have mentioned that electrical neutrality is maintained. So whenever there is an anion vacancy, for maintaining the electrical neutrality, what will happen is an extra electron will be there in place of the anion. So here, from here, say A is missing, and extra electron, by which is represented by E with a negative charge, has occupied its space. So this is generally introduced in NaCl or KCl type of structure, where Schottky defects are, which are more prone to Schottky defects when we talk about the stoichiometric defects. So these non-stoichiometric defects occur to the crystals, which are more prone to the Schottky defects. So these example is NaCl and KCl, which were the examples of Schottky. So NaCl and KCl, when they are heated with vapors of sodium or potassium, what will happen is, or we can say high energy radiations, what will happen is the composition becomes the chloride ions from the NaCl or KCl goes missing. The composition becomes air. Here A is representing the sodium or potassium, that is the alkali metal, and chloride ion is represented by X. So the formula becomes AX1 minus delta. The delta number of chloride ions goes missing. So why this has happened? Because the excess sodium vapors or potassium vapors which are present, it took away the chloride ions from these crystals. So so here the chloride ions goes missing. So the real time example for this case is that sodium chloride, when heated in the sodium vapors, what will happen? It becomes yellow in color, which depicts that it has gone non-stoichiometric, that it chloride ion has gone from its structure, its lattice. Also, it becomes yellow in color. Now, the yellow color refers to the situation that there are trapped electrons in the anion vacancies, which are called as Farbe centers, which is a German word for F. This is a German word, Farbe centers. So these Farbe centers are the reason for the color of the sodium chloride, which becomes yellow in color when heated in sodium vapors. So next we have the extra cation in the interstitial site, metal excess case, where the metal excess situation is achieved by the extra cation in the interstitial site. So this extra cation is present in the interstitial site to maintain the electrical neutrality, and extra electron would also occupy the interstitial site, as we have to maintain the electrical neutrality. Whenever there is a missing cation or missing anion, we'll have to take out electrons also. And whenever there is an extra cation is present, then we'll have to supply, provide electrons to in the interstitial site. So this type of defect, that is extra cation, when extra cation occupies the interstitial site, this is found in crystals which are likely for Frenkel defect, because what happens there is the cation from the actual site position occupies the interstitial site. So whenever there is a possibility of cation occupying the interstitial sites, that is the where such type of crystals were prone to Frenkel defect. So when such crystals are here we have given heat treatment in the cation vapors to such crystals. Here in case of extra cation in interstitial site, what we will do the example is zinc oxide. At high temperature, it loses oxygen reversibly. When oxygen is lost, then there is an extra zinc ions present. Then those zinc ions which are extra, because oxygen has already gone, so these zinc ions will occupy the interstitial site, and the corresponding electrical neutrality will be maintained by the extra electrons present in the interstitial site. So in such cases, electrical conductivity is observed because of the extra electrons present. Now, the consequences of metal excess defects. Metal excess defects introduce increased conductance by the crystal, because as the magnitude of defect is decreased, the conductance is also decreased in comparison to metals. Such crystals behave as semiconductors. So these are called as n-type semiconductors, because the current carrier, the electrical conductivity which has been introduced, is due to the extra electrons present in the lattice, which are negatively charged, and represents the negative means n-type of semiconductors have been introduced here. So the crystals generally become colored due to free electrons, or those free electrons are called as Farbe centers, which is a German word for free. Next type of defect, here we have discussed two types of defects for the non-stoichiometric compounds. One was metal excess, then another was metal deficiency. Metal excess was having further two cases. Now we are discussing the metal deficiency, which is further having two cases, that is cation vacancy and excess anion in interstitial site. So first is the cation vacancy. What happens is cation goes missing, and excess negative charge will be balanced by some nearby cation occupying additional positive charge. Say we have the example of iron oxide or iron sulfide, where so this condition for this is, here we have written C1 representing condition for this is where metal ions can exist in variable oxidation state. Say for iron oxide, iron can exist as +2 and +3. Iron +2 and +3 are both are stable. So if we say Fe2 plus ion is missing, then the corresponding two neighboring Fe2 plus ions will change their oxidation state to Fe3 plus, thus maintaining the electrical neutrality. So the which there the conductance is going to be there due to these starts. So there will be the exchange of electrons start taking place between the neighboring Fe2 and Fe3 plus ions, leading to generation of metallic luster. That is why metallic luster is present in some minerals, and those are confused with metals, and thus is the we have a mineral which is also called as fool's gold. The metallic luster of fool's gold is due to that this particular condition only, that there is a defect that, which is called as cation vacancy, where the nearby cations have increased their positive charge to maintain the electrical neutrality. So the second category of this is excess anion in the interstitial site. This defect is generally very uncommon because anions, being bigger in size, they are very reluctant to occupy the interstitial site. So extra anion occupying the interstitial sites will lead to the nearby cations increasing its oxidation state. Similar thing is going to take place, that in both the cases, the cation is going to increase its oxidation state. In the first case, it was due to missing cation, and in the second case, it was due to the extra anion present in the interstitial site. But this extra anion category, this extra anion case is very uncommon due to the large size of anions. Now, this is having some consequences. There is a conductance. These type of defects also lead to the conductance of the conductance of the sample which are having these defects. Now this conductance is due to the movement of electrons only, but actually what happens is what appears to us is that there is a movement of holes is taking place from A positive to as A positive is becoming A to 2 positive. That means there is a movement of positive charge. We can positive charge, we denote them by holes. So if there is a movement of holes, then these type of semiconductors are called as P type of semiconductors when they conduct electricity. So this is all about defects in ionic solids, ionic crystals. So we have discussed firstly, there are two types of defects, stoichiometric, non-stoichiometric. Stoichiometric are of further two types, Schottky and Prandtl. Then further non-stoichiometric compounds, there are two types of defects, metal excess and metal deficiency. Metal excess is further can be achieved by two types, that is anion vacancy and extra cation in interstitial sites. And metal deficiency can be further achieved by two types, that is cation vacancy and extra anion in interstitial sites. So this is all about the defects in crystal lattices, defects in crystals. So in the next video, we'll be discussing about the semiconductors. So that is it for this video. Thank you so much. Have a good day.